good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and on behalf of the Surrey Registration Service, we'd like to welcome you all to this beautiful setting, the Manor House Hotel, and hope you all have an enjoyable and memorable day. And of course, a very warm welcome to the two most important people here, Mark and Bea. You are all special guests gathered here today, as you are the dear family and close friends of Mark and Bea. And I'm sure you would join me in my sentiment of wishing the two of you the happiest of days. As today, Saturday the 25th of January 2014, is your wedding day. It is a day that will hold precious memories for years to come, and a date that will always be celebrated principally by the two of you and by your extended family. And it's a date you in particular, Mark, need to put in your diary. And before we begin the ceremony, I would like to take a few moments to introduce ourselves. My name is Alison Brock, and to my left is my friend and colleague, Chloe Bray. We are both registrars based in Guildford, and Chloe will be registering your marriage today and making the legal and indeed historical record of the event. To those of you unfamiliar with the marriage ceremony, it involves the exchange of vows by means of two declarations. Now, Mark and Bea, although everyone here knows you very well, the law does require that you must both fully identify yourselves. So, Mark, can I have your full names, please?
Mark Gary Billing.
Thank you. And Bea, your full names, please?
Sushila Shura.
Thank you. The place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to the law for the celebration of marriages. And you are all here today to witness the joining in matrimony of Mark and Bea. Marriage is a celebration of the love which two people share. The ceremony provides the opportunity to bring friends and family together in one place to celebrate the happiness of the couple and to witness what is at heart a very private moment between two people as they commit to each other for the future. Mark and Bea, you have come together today to formally unite and pledge your love for one another and to offer to each other the security which comes from vows sincerely made and faithfully kept. Before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding contract of the vows you are about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is a union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. But further, it is also a union that ought to provide the love, comfort, friendship and support that each ought to have for the other, both in times of joy and in times of difficulty, not to be entered into lightly or lightly put to one side. Now I'm going to ask each of you in turn to declare that there is no lawful reason why you cannot be married here today, and we will be delighted to hear that groom always goes first. So I'd like to ask you to face each other, please, and I'd like the two witnesses, Frankie and Claire, to please stand and support. And Mark, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I.
Why I.
Mark Gary Billing.
Mark Gary Billing.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Sushada Shurat.
To Sushada Shurat.
I do solemnly declare.
Solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any.
Of any.
Lawful impediment.
Lawful impediment.
Why I.
Why I.
Sushada Shura.
Sushada Shura.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Mark Gary Pilling.
To Mark Gary Pilling.
And now the solemn moment has come for you both to contract your marriage vows. So again, Mark, I'm going to ask you to go first. I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present.
Here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Mark Gary Pilling.
Mark Gary Pilling.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Sushada Shurat.
Sushada Shurat.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present.
Here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Sushada Shurat.
Sushada Shurat.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Mark Gary Pilling.
Mark Gary Pilling.
To be my lawful.
To be my lawful.
Wedded husband.
Wedded husband.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is it. I could ask you to sit down again, please. Can you tell me, please? Mark and B, you are about to make promises to one another. Today these vows and beautiful words represent even more beautiful intentions. You will find as you live these vows over the years, investing your time, your love and your commitment to one another, that happy times will be twice as happy because you will always have that special person by your side. And when life becomes difficult, as it sometimes will, it will only be half as bad because that special person will be there to help you through. Now, I believe that there's going to be an exchange of rings, and that task has fallen to Frankie. Lots of rolls today. Thank you so much. The giving of the wedding ring is the ancient and traditional way of sealing your contract with one another. A wedding ring is an unbroken circle which symbolises unending and everlasting love and is the outward sign of the lifelong promises that you are making to each other here today. So Mark, I'd like to invite you to take the ring that you're going to present to me and place it just at the top of the third finger of her left hand, just at the top, holding her hand. I'd like to say these words to thee. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
In celebration.
In celebration.
Of our marriage.
Of our marriage.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
All that I have.
All that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Comfort you.
Comfort you.
And give you friendship.
And give you friendship.
And support.
And support.
Through all our time together.
Through all our time together.
This is my promise.
This is my promise.
To you today.
To you today.
And for the rest of my life.
And for the rest of my life.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
And I accept your ring.
And I accept your ring.
In celebration.
In celebration.
Of our marriage.
Of our marriage.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
All that I have.
All that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Comfort you.
Comfort you.
And give you friendship.
And give you friendship.
And support.
And support.
Through all our time,
to all our time
together.
Together.
This is my promise.
This is my promise.
To you today.
To you today.
And for the rest of my life.
And for the rest of my life.
And I push that in you.
Squeeze it off.
Mark and B, with every day you live, find things within yourselves that you can share with each other. Have an open heart and a sincere mind. Be concerned with each other's happiness. Be constant and consistent in your love. May you never take each other for granted, but always experience the wonder of your love. May your life together be a source of strength and inspiration to yourselves, to your friends, and to your families. May you never forget the beginning of your love for one another. Take care of it and allow it to grow strong and firm in the years that are about to come. May you always concentrate on making each other happy and secure in your commitment to one another. May you always be in love. Remember that first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. You are two persons with one life ahead of you. And in joining your lives today, may you both be granted a special lifetime together. Marriage is giving generously from the heart and is learning to share, and is part of the commitment that you have made to each other here today. So, the vows that you have said are the ones required by law. You have made a solemn and binding contract in the presence of this, your family, witnesses and friends, myself and Chloe. And it really does give me the very greatest of pleasure to say yes. From this moment on, you are husband and wife together. Now, Mark, are you going to give your wife a kiss?
Yeah.
Come on, then. Okay, that's my little toe. We've got a dryer in the house. I'm going to hand you over to Chloe, so to organise the signing of the register. This is a private moment between the two of you and two witnesses, so no photographs at this stage, but we'll set you up with a box shortly. So take a few seats.
Mrs. Pilling, can you have a sweet face?
Today for this fabulous couple. We hope you have a wonderful afternoon, and without any further notice, can't think of the right words, I'd like to introduce you to the very newest Mr. and Mrs. Pilling.
Did. From Stagner Point, Stagner.
It was alright, she just ended
it. Yeah, I moved it around a bit, done some.
Yeah.
still get it out. We might be.
How's it going? You got some good footage?
Some edit, you know, a lot of editing. But yeah.
To give her away. Thank you, Freddie. I'm proud to come off the subs bench for this fixture. I would like to thank everybody who helped organise this wedding, especially Nikki. When I first met Bea, I was struck by how friendly and natural she was. I could tell right away how much they liked each other. I know that with Mark, Bea will be part of a great and loving partnership. And from what I've seen, they will be a great team. This will stand them in good stead as their family grows. I'm sure that you'll all join with me in wishing Mark and Bea every success and happiness for the future. So, will you all please rise for a toast? Would you be sure? Mark and Bea, every good wish for your future together, the bride and groom. I'm sorry. I now give you the broom.
Thank you.
words. I love doing speeches. Thank you, Dad, for those very kind words. I meant a great deal to be on myself when you gave your words. Thank you so much. On behalf of my wife and I, we're thankful. Yay! Yay! We'd like to say a big thank you for everyone for coming today. It literally wouldn't have been the same without any of you here. You're all incredibly close to me and Bea, and thank you all so much for coming. See what happens. Before I start, I'd like to say take a second to just talk about those who are not with us today. Life can at times be too short, but I know that they're looking down on us, and we're sure that they're not only in our thoughts but also in our hearts. So if everyone could raise your glasses.
Absent friends.
And join a toast to absent friend, family and friends.
Absent friends.
And now for the thank yous. To my mum and to my dad, biggest thank you of the day, definitely. And if I don't get this right, my mum will definitely kill me. So thank you both so much, not just for today, but for being the best parents a boy could ask for. Words cannot really describe just how much I love you both. If I could be half a good parent as both of you, then I know we're doing a good job.
Get the tissues out.
In terms of the wedding, today literally wouldn't have been possible without my mum's help, who has done absolutely everything, not just financially, as well as my dad, who's helped us, but my mum's pretty much organised everything. Even making sure I packed my pants this morning. Which I have written. And thank God she actually said that this morning as well. I have a gift for both of you actually, which hopefully is underneath here. There's another half to this gift.
Thank you.
That you'll both get later. It's a really pretty bag for you, Simon. I know you like it. So if everyone could please again raise a glass and toast to my mum and dad.
Mum and dad.
The bridesmaid, Claire Thompson. I'm incredibly, incredibly grateful actually for the support and friendship you've given to me since you were asked. I know it means a great deal to her, and it does to me that you looked after her massively well, so thank you so much. Thank you. Winding me up throughout the years. Ben, Jack, Lee and Matt. Getting to this point without crying has been quite difficult, so I thank you all for doing that. on a more serious note, we just wouldn't say that, we wouldn't be here. Love them, so thank you so much. And the bridesmaids. Now for Frankie, the best man. I've known Frankie since I was born, basically. So when it came to choosing my best man, it was incredibly easy. Unfortunately, he wasn't available, so I had to pick you. seriously. Thank you so much for getting me through today and for being there forever. You know, I love you. Thanks for organising a very painful stag do. And for an advance, probably a very painful best man to be. if everyone could raise a glass to the best man, Frankie.
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 Best man.
Now, I'm going to cry. So I'm talking about my wife. Most important speech of the evening, if not my life. You look absolutely beautiful. Completely stunning. There was a saying that you don't marry someone you can live with, you marry someone you can't live without. I think that sums us up really well. Watching you walk up the aisle today just made me realise just how lucky I am. I looked at myself and realised it was definitely me getting the best part of this deal. Me, marrying a family. As most of you would have noticed, B is pregnant and we're expecting our first child in March. We're both so excited to be parents and I can't wait till our little boy joins us. I feel immensely proud and fortunate to be able to have a baby with you, so thank you. If everyone can rise and raise a glass to the bride and bump. To my family, I'd like to say a big thank you to all of you, because I love you all so much, and particularly my nan, who I know has been there for me since I was born.
You said you didn't want any barracking, I'm sorry.
You know, she's getting on a bit now, but...
I'm
97. thank you all so much. Because I love you all very, very much.
Love you.
To B's family. Unfortunately, they can't be here with us today. It's a massive shame, really, to me. I'm sure to be. But even so, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank them for allowing me to marry their daughter and for accepting me as a son-in-law, because I promise I'll do them proud. And please, can everyone raise a glass to family?
B's family. Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Are you crying, B?
I really love you. Really.
So please cry.
I thought of ways in which I can get her family involved in the day. I managed to actually get a video of B's family. For whatever reason, B's already seen that. Won't go into detail, I'll tell you later. But in addition, I have a little surprise for her, hopefully. But it really depends on
technology.
And technology is a really interesting thing. So I'm going to take a second to talk about technology. Basically, if everything works, that's B's mum on the right. And Ben will have to turn the sound on as well.
Oh dear.
I'll have to come round. Not in the script.
Oh,
stand up, Reese. Go and talk to her.
Make them
hear you.
Maybe go and talk.
Can
they see
Sawadi.
Sawadi.
Say bye, Nimai.
It's not working, it's very slow, but it's fine. But they can see us anyway.
They can see you. Yeah. You can see your mum, Debbie.
It's like Debbie in the white t-shirt. Is that your dad?
Yeah, that's,
yeah, that's my dad on the right.
That's Bee's dad on the right.
That's your mum on the left.
Yeah. She has scarf because it's quite cold at the moment. But.
Okay.
They can't hear it.
Say hello. Say hello.
I can't.
No.
Kelly now.
Thank you. Before I pass over to the best man, I'd just like to say that I have no ideas what stories he's going to make up. I'm quite worried about it, if I'm being honest. However, as my character is so unblemished, why is everyone laughing? He may have to report to making something up, so please take anything he tells you with the appropriate pinch of salt. Thank you all, and I'll hand over to Frankie, my best man. Mm-hmm. Pressure's on you now, motherfucker.
That's toilet paper.
You're better than what I'm going to say, so I've got a joke to start with. 5-year-old Susie was telling her mother the story of Snow White, which she'd heard in school. She was coming to the end and she said, "And then Prince Charming kissed Snow White back to life." And little Susie said, "And Mum, do you know what happened then?" Mum said, "Yes. They lived happily ever after." Little Susie said, with a frown, "No, Mum, they got married." So, that's it. That's all I wanted to say. So, ladies and gentlemen, for those that don't know me, let me introduce myself. My name is Frankie Tomlinson. Mark's given me the great honour of being his best man. So, I haven't been involved in too many weddings, so I had to do some Googling, as you would. Apparently, had we been in Zambia, I would have been expected to entertain you all with an outlandish and evocative solo dance performance. I might throw that in later. Had we been in Uganda, I would have been expected to educate the newlyweds in the ways of marriage. No, I don't know what that means. Get me along on the honeymoon and I'll do my best. God forbid, had we been in Greece, I would have been expected to pay for the wedding. Luckily, we're in England, and my duties were to organise a stag do, to give a bit of advice about wedding and suits and things like that, and to give this speech. So I had to ask Mark what I was allowed to put in the speech, obviously, because you have to. Number one was don't mention the stag do. Number two, seriously, don't mention the stag do. Number three, don't mention the ex-girlfriends. There was an S in there, but I think it was an error, because... anyway, you cut 3 seconds off my speech. So I better start by congratulating you both. Congratulations. You both are excellent, brilliant, solid choice of spouse. Well done. The groom, the bride and the bump look absolutely splendid. B, you look radiant, happy. And B, you look radiant, happy and look like you're enjoying yourself immensely. It's brilliant. Mark, 4 out of 10. No, B, make a sunny bride. Mark, you're a very lucky man. As they say in Thailand, Kun Suai Mak Mak. Oh, thank you. Now that loses something in translation, but it sort of comes across as, Mark, you've done very well, but you run for your life. What are you thinking? I certainly have had a great time today, and I hope you have too. Mark looks like he's sweating profusely still. I recently got married. I remember being fearful of three things. One was having to give the groom speech, two was the first dance, and three was the best man speech. Now, I've seen Mark dance, and once enough, so I understand that he's going to share that fear. I've heard him speak, which was very good, actually, Mark, well done, and I know what I'm about to reveal, so his fear's justified. Before I do get into his character assassination, sorry about the speech, I believe it's my duty to compliment the bridesmaid. I've made my personal feelings regarding Claire pretty clear when I married her last year. So, yeah, very good. Pretty good. And B, thanks for choosing someone who I've done a fair amount of groundwork with and have a semi-decent chance of placing. So, reaction to the engagement. Well, I must admit, I was when I got the phone call from Mark, I was pretty shocked. Quiet voice. He asked me what I thought about marriage. Frank, what do you think about marriage? I told him, mate, we've been friends for a long time, and I feel I can be honest with you. I'll give you some solid advice. Marriage is something. It's a commitment. You live with someone every day. You wake up with them every morning. And it's the rest of your life. I said, I'll settle for being best man, why don't you ask B? It worked pretty well. He planned it very well. He drove up to Edinburgh to surprise B. He picked the perfect ring, picked the perfect location. I don't know if any of you know Edinburgh, but Arthur's Seat, absolutely stunning. Place of amazing natural beauty, fantastic views. Unfortunately, it's 800 feet of climb as well. I think he made it about halfway up. Before falling to our knee, the ring sort of rolled down. But he was like, oh yeah, that sounds good. And that's how we're here, so well done, Mark. So I've known him quite literally as long as I can remember. As Mark said, we met aged about 1 year of age. And although I'm a little bit older, I think he's probably a slightly quicker developer. He's always had a hairier chest, more facial hair. And that came across quite early on when he took the role of parent and teacher. I first learnt to feed via spoon rather than breast or bottle because of Mark's fantastic education, which was, I still use those lessons. Later he showed me how to avoid baths by just stripping your clothes and jumping into sort of paddling pools and ponds, and again, very useful. Thank you, Mark. I've spent too many an hour naked in a paddling pool with you, probably. Probably more than you have been. Later, aged 4 or 5, he continued my education by showing me how the correct use of red underpants and blue trousers made it exactly like Superman. And it's still one of my favourite outfits, to be honest. I've got it on underneath. If anyone is interested. We grew up 20 metres from one another's doorstep, which was an amazing privilege, really. And Nicky and Simon were like second parents, and Mark is like a brother to me. And at the time, it was a simple but invaluable thing to have one's best friend so close. We spent time together almost every day, playing football, churning the gardens into mud pits, destroying the lounge, having sleepovers, planning adventures, having adventures, all the things that kids do, really enjoying our childhood. And 20 metres was a great distance. These days, I've moved 200 miles away from Mark, and prefer to love him from that distance. Yeah. 20 metres is positively dangerous these days. He's a champion snorer, as I'm sure B could do. In fact, I recently stayed at his house on a visit from Devon. After a few beers, wandered by to investigate what sounded like a tsunami, to be honest. And to my horror, discovered that it was Mark, and he had fallen out of a few habits, which I tried to teach him during our childhood. So he didn't close the bedroom door anymore, doesn't wear pyjamas, doesn't use a bed cover, and doesn't lie on his back. So needless to say, we don't do sleepovers that much anymore. No, I didn't have much
breakfast. Chicken pilatas.
So Mark and I have had our, you know, downs as well as our ups, of course, everyone does. During the difficult years of adolescence, we got ourselves into a fair amount of trouble.
Did you?
Yeah, well. Being the alpha male he is. Scary, looking, muscular, butch, intimidating, slightly cocky. Mark naturally caused a bit of friction with the local kids. And this somehow always resulted in me being walloped. On one particular occasion, after Mark had paid a few too many compliments to a local girl called Cheryl, we found ourselves, as was par for the course, legging it across Belfield's estate, being followed by a much older, angrier and spottier teenager. We were on our bikes at the time and frankly not doing a good job of getting away. Mark had the great idea of splitting up in order to confuse our pursuits. You can imagine who they chase and who they get away. About 10 minutes later, after being rescued by a local granny, I was, you know, midway through taking a solid beating and made my way back to Nicky's house. "Where the heck have you been, Frank?" was Mark's reply. "You lost our race." He was nodding his head towards his mum, and, you know, who was standing in the doorway looking worried. We never used to tell our parents we got into trouble.
No, that's just who we were.
All I could say was, "Yeah, you won, mate. Nice one." And largely because I'm such a competitive git, I've never managed to forgive him for that one. So a little about stag do. Now, recent events that we've already had heard mentioned about Mark's sperm and Bee's uterus stopped us going to anywhere to like Las Vegas or Amsterdam. We ended up in Brighton, and a great bunch of lads made the effort to come down. It was some good wholesome fun. We ended up paintballing on Saturday morning. It was pretty nasty weather. Everyone fairly quickly gave up shooting at anyone else and just saved the paintballs for the stag run at the end. We discovered it was a bit of a misnomer. It wasn't a run, it was more of a firing squad. And it wasn't just the stag, it was me as well. So I didn't enjoy that part of the discovery. Hardened men we are, I can say neither of us broke or ran. We both had some sporting bruises to prove it. Mark more than me. If anyone hasn't seen the photo, come and find me later, I'll show you. He gave a good account of himself in the evening also, and despite large quantities of alcohol, didn't actually do anything too stupid that I'm going to mention here. Although I must say, the gimp suit and thong went down really well.
It felt really good.
Any chafing?
Find me later for photos. So I'm meant to get some advice at this stage, and after just over a year of marriage, I feel I'm quite well qualified. Nothing here should be doubted at all. So never go to sleep on an argument, Mark. Always stay awake and fight. The best way to remember your anniversary is to forget it once. If you're ever stuck about what to say to make amends, always remember the three little words, "You're right, dear." In times of trouble, remember the wisdom of Oscar Wilde. Women are meant to be loved, not to be understood. And this one's for everyone that's come as a couple. So if you look into the eyes of whoever you've come with, and just think about the things that have brought you together, and then think, statistically, that I can reveal to you, you are lovingly gazing at the one person on the planet most likely to murder you. The last one's for Bee, actually. Did you know, Bee, that an anagram of mother-in-law is woman Hitler? Nicky, no reflection on you. So I haven't got many messages from loved ones, because Mark will organise the video link. Just the one. To Mark, we are so sorry we couldn't make your big day. We hope you guys have a great time. We just felt too emotional to be losing such a wonderful guy. It was so fun to meet you in Brighton, and we will sure to see you soon. From all the girls at Grace's Palace.
Guys.
So I'm going to start to round it up, and let me just say how lucky you both are. You found brilliant people in one another. Mark, you leave today having gained a wife who is warm, caring and kind, a wife who has a great sense of humour and who balances you, who radiates beauty wherever she goes, a wife who will be a brilliant mother to your young boy. V, how lucky you are, leaving today having gained a gorgeous dress. Now, Mark was, in his earlier years, a very passionate guy who sometimes struggled to control his temper. Yeah. Strange decisions. He had some nasty habits and some nasty hygiene issues.
Still
these days, he's matured into a kind and considerate person. He has many fine qualities, sometimes showers and occasionally shaves. Now, in truth, Mark is one of the best men that I know. He has an accurate moral compass. He lives by honest values. He is a hard worker, a loving person, and puts his family and friends before anything else. I'm sure these qualities will make him an excellent husband and father, as excellent a husband and father is his best friend. I wish you both a lifetime of happiness, and I remind you that I'm still free for the Godfather role. I finish with a traditional wedding toast. Here's to your coffins. May they be made of 100-year-old oaks, which we shall plant tomorrow. May you both live as long as you want, and never want as long as you live. May the best of your yesterdays be the worst of your tomorrows. So can we all raise our glasses to the happy couple, Mr. and Mrs. Billy?
Mr.
and Mrs. Billy. Thanks very much.
That was really good.
Well done, Frankie.
Almost as good as mine, very good. Oh, I
think I said that.
Mark, don't worry about tonight and the consummation bit. I think you've already done that bit. Have a good one, though.
I don't know what you said, Sharon.
Go.
Ready? Congratulations. I hope you both be very happy. Lots of love from Josie and John. Congratulations, Mark and Steve. I'm sure you're very happy together. And good luck in the future.
Congratulations, Mark and B. It was lovely to meet you at last, B. And all the best for the future and your little one. Good luck. Bye.
For my wonderful grandson, my equally wonderful, what is she going to be? My cut
carrier.
To my wonderful bee, I wish you all the happiness in the world, and I can't wait to see my great grandson.
Okay, good. I'm proud of you, darling. You've done a wonderful job. You've chosen so well, and we love you.
Bad choice in the curry the night before. I've been sitting next to you for the entire evening, and it smells bad.
Well, then, absolutely wicked, mate. Well done. Congratulations. All the best.
Michael.
Listen.
Well done, Marky boy and Marky girl.
Hang on, go.
Well, Mark, good choice. Good day. Great, thanks.
That was really good. We had the one there.
Thanks for inviting me. I don't know you that well, but what I hear from Bob, it's all good. So, best wishes for your wedding. And
thank you.
Congratulations, Mark and B. I think you make a wonderful couple, and it's a great honour to be invited to your wedding. Thank you very much for inviting us. It's been great.
Blah, blah, blah. God, your speech killed me. I've listened to it all week. And you still failed with it. Love you, really. Congratulations to you and me. Fantastic.
Three, two, one, cut the cake!
Before we go into the first dance, we would like to kind of throw the bouquet. So what I'm looking for, please, is single, unmarried ladies, please. That's the criteria. No, sorry, sir. You have a skirt, we might let you in, but no trousers. Sorry? Not too late. Single, unmarried ladies. You know the tradition of the throwing of the bouquet. Hang on, they're still gathering. Have we got all the ladies that wish to participate? Please, the rules are no standing on someone else's shoulder, and if you put that chair back, that's cheating. Anyway, if you're ready, in reverse, 3, 2, 1. Yep. Here we go, you guys want to help us count them down? 3, 2, 1, let it go!
It's a fix!
Now we're looking, see you back here, madam, same time, next year perhaps. So Mark, if you can kind of join me.
What a fix that was.
First dance.
Yeah, I know.
May I escort you on the dance floor? Of course you may. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the first dance together as Mr. and Mrs. Beautiful song, you've got to listen to the words of this one by Ed Sheeran.
You did it, didn't you?
Bitch. Sorry. It's that woman over there in the shop trying to get her out.
Thank you.
Just like to say that his boss isn't really a dick.
well done, Mark. All the best for the future, mate. Well done.
Bye, Mark. We're going to make such good marriage and be happy.
Not to mention boss, but I'll be happy future together.
Lots of love. We love you. We're going to babysit the baby. Lots of love. Free as well. I'll do it at no cost.
I will charge.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Congratulations. And have a best future. Thank you. Thank you very much for your
invitation as well. Say it.
Hi Mark, it's your Auntie Shasha here. I hope you appreciate me getting everyone to send you this message, and now it's my turn. So I just want to say have a fantastic day, and it has been a fantastic day. Have a wonderful life together, and I'm looking forward to your new baby boy so I can spoil him like I spoilt you. But boy, you are worth it. Love you loads, Mark, and to you, V. You're a wonderful, stunningly beautiful and very lovely person. Take care to you both. Bye. Love you loads.
Hello, hope Mark and B have had a lovely, lovely, lovely day. Can't believe my little boy's just got married. I think he's not a little boy anymore, I might have to call him a big boy. Oh, that sounds wrong, but you know what I mean. really, really pleased that he's picked B because she's lovely, and I'm very excited that she's going to be my daughter-in-law, and I'm very excited that we're going to have a little baby. So very excited, it's been a perfect day. Love you both lots. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Mark and B, you're amazing. Like, I've lived with you for like a few months now, and I'm so happy for you both. Like, you found love. Like, it's amazing. It's the best thing you can find in life, and I'm really, really happy for you both. So well done, and make sure you keep it going.
Thank you.
Boom.
Mark and B, congratulations on your big day. It's been very emotional. Cheers to the future. Hip hip hooray.
So much, and I will love you forever.